You don't have to do this. Why is it so important?
It just is.
It touches you.
It does. It's important to me.
There may be no figure in show business as legendary as Jennifer Lopez. Don't stop, keep it moving, put your drinks up. With smash hits like On the Floor. And I'm Real. From the dance floor to the big screen, and even on music's biggest stage, her name synonymous with the word success. The superstar has sold more than 70 million records worldwide, and together, her movies have earned a total of $3.1 billion. And at 52 years old, J-Lo is still plowing full steam ahead, helping to launch a bold new initiative to support Latina entrepreneurs and releasing a new documentary on Netflix.
Part of being a great performer is being aware of whoever's around me right there. You feel me?
In the film Halftime, J-Lo pulls back the curtain on the 2020 Super Bowl halftime show that made history. Super Bowl! It was the first time two Latina artists headlined the world's biggest stage. But with the NFL's decision to have J-Lo and Shakira share top billing came frustration. It meant the hitmakers would need to split their time. Lopez saying in the documentary, this was the worst idea in the world.
I'm trying to give you something with substance. I want something real.
The doc revealing she fought to make her show pointed and political. In a reference to the immigration crisis, putting children, including her own daughter, in cages on stage, and draping herself in a Puerto Rican flag.
Only be 5 minutes, you'll be here, okay?
In this exclusive clip from Halftime, J-Lo revealing what she told her daughter.
I said, you look right down that camera, and you tell every little girl in the world to get loud and to never, ever back down from bringing light to injustice. That year was just turned out to be an incredible year for me, where everything I had worked for my whole life just kind of exploded in 1 year. All right, now bring it back.
Known affectionately as Jenny from the Block. I'm still Jenny from the Block. Used to have a little, now I have a lot. J-Lo has always stayed true to her Bronx roots and humble beginnings.
You knocked down some roadblocks to build what is now an empire.
Thank you.
How did you do it?
You know, I have to thank my mom and my dad, who really instilled in me that I could do anything I wanted to do.
At the MTV Awards, yes. You made a very emotional acceptance speech.
In which you said, I want to thank the people who gave me joy and the ones who broke my heart, the ones who were true and the ones who lied to me.
You said, I want to thank those who lied to me, those who told me I couldn't do this. What did failure and disappointment teach you?
It taught me to have to believe in myself. I had to. It forced me to do that.
J-Lo's latest project is about giving back.
Honestly, I'm hoping to kind of change the fabric of America, especially for Latino women.
The music icon, following an introduction by Goldman Sachs, now partnering with nonprofit Grameen America. It's led by Andrea Jung, the longest-serving female CEO of a Fortune 500 company.
So our goal together is by 2030 to give out $14 billion of loan capital.
That makes me smile.
$14 billion. $14 billion. And it's a lot of loans. And we are going to touch 600,000 women entrepreneurs.
Honestly, I'm still pinching myself. I can't believe this is happening.
One out of four businesses are Latinx owned in terms of small businesses in the United States.
One out of every four?
Over the last 10 years, they've grown 44%. And for women, Latino women entrepreneurs, the number's even higher.
A 2020 report found that Latino-owned businesses are significantly less likely than similar white-owned businesses to have loans approved by national banks.
The biggest hurdle for any minority group?
I think there are so many systemic hurdles, Don, that we're all fighting, but one of them clearly is fair access to capital. And when you look at the pathway to financial inclusion, over 50% of women in America are underbanked or unbanked.
And I want to empower that community even more. And I think, you know, nobody wants a handout. They want to be able to build their own businesses. We want our own opportunities. We don't want to be there just because. We want to be there because we're just as good as.
The average loan size is about $5,000. But along with the money, recipients also receive mentorship and financial literacy education.
These are women who've been historically excluded from the financial mainstream. And often they come to the program with no credit score or a poor credit score because no one's taught them about credit card debt.
And that's where I come in. It's like letting Latina women know, hey, this opportunity exists out here. You can go get this loan. If you need that $3,000 for that first month's rent for that business that you want, you can get it. You can have it. You know, the payback on this is like they pay back the loans like 90s. Quickly. The percentages. 99.6%. She's better with all the percentages and the numbers than I am.
But it's like 99% are paid back.
It's crazy. It's crazy. It's like one of the best investments you can make in this country, I believe.
Jennifer, why are Latinas so important to this country? What do they bring?
Oh my goodness.
That no other group can.
She used a great word, which I use all the time, which is grit. They're just tough. They're strong. They're made from a certain kind of fabric.
Ganas.
Yes. Tienen gana. Tienen chispa. They are entrepreneurial. They are inventive. They are creative. I'm still
Jenny from the block. Just like Jenny from the block, who's never forgotten where she came from.
You've got the documentary, you've got this wonderful
yes.
new initiative.
Yes, yes.
And you've got an engagement.
I do.
And of course, I've got to ask about Ben.
Yeah, okay.
How's it going?
I mean, this is the best time of my life. I love my career, but nothing is more fulfilling to me than being able to build a family with someone who I love deeply and who is just as dedicated to family and to each other as we can be. And I feel incredibly blessed.
When is the wedding?
I can't give you that one. Sorry.
Hi everyone, George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.